right, so let's continue along with our example of the sledder going down the hill. In this case, we're going to examine the three forces that are acting. Now, let's stop the sledder. We're going to take a moment where the sledder is not moving. That means that the force of friction that's acting back against the sledder is actually going to be static friction in that case.
Okay. And because there's no motion, I mean, there's no velocity, there's no acceleration. So according to Newton's laws, then if there's zero acceleration, the net force has to be zero. Okay. These three need to cancel out.
So we can say that the sum of forces acting in our system is equal to zero.
Right. Now, if we're going to do that, we could line things up tip to tail and those vectors will cancel out. But it's a lot more systematic and helpful to break things into components. We typically break problems into X and Y.
Right.
So let me draw dotted lines. And what we'll find is that according to Newton's law, the sum of the forces acting, say, in the X direction should cancel by themselves. And then the sum of the forces acting in the Y direction should also cancel.
Now, in order to do that, we'll need some angles. So let's incline this slope at an angle of theta.
Okay, and that should play in somewhere here. You can see that we've got two vectors that we're going to have to break into components. So where does this angle fit into our free body diagram?
Well, the force of static friction acts in this direction along the slope. So that means that this angle is also theta here.
Okay. For the normal force, it's a little harder. The normal force is always going to be perpendicular to that incline. Now, if there was no incline, if it was horizontal to the ground, then the normal force would be this way. But because we've got an incline at a certain angle, we've rotated through theta to get there, the normal force has to rotate through the same angle, starting from vertical over to the side. So yeah, perfect.
All right, well now let's break it into X and Y components.
Okay, let's look at horizontally first. I'll list things off here. The normal force has a component acting in the positive X direction, and we could get that by N sine theta. The friction force has a component in the negative X direction, opposing it, and that we're gonna get as F cos theta. Those two forces will cancel out. In the Y direction, we've got two upward forces. Normal force has a positive Y component that we get by N times cos theta. Added to that, the friction force has a vertical component, F times sine theta, and those both work against the downward or negative force of gravity. So Newton's second law says that if there is no acceleration, the net force is zero, and we've broken things into components to show that these two expressions are consistent with Newton's laws. And from this point, we could use those to solve for an unknown force. Maybe perhaps we're after the friction in this problem.